May I introduce you to Dr. Clara Maurel.
Here we go. Yo. We got the deeper insight into a meteorite. It's magnetism and its durability over time. Yeah, Clara's been in the fight to try to see the insides of the cloudy zones up in the tetratinite. And yeah, she's reading it right. And now we're seeing the light, inferring the parent body of a meteorite. Even a meteorite that's kilometers in size, thanks to Clara Maurel's PhD insight. So MIT, get it right. And tell everybody the magnetic properties of meteorites and their parent bodies, and the need to resolve the speculated existence of intermediates between chondritic and achondritic. How does a meteorite record a magnetic field when it coalesces into a planetesimal shell? And did it have magnetic resonance when it first fell into a farmer's field? Better call Clara Maurel, cause it's hard to tell unless you can measure the function of the tinite grains, those tiny magnetic compasses. And then you see that when you wipe the meteorite right with acid, you see the elegant vidmash dad in pattern hashes. And then you can zoom in closer and find the rim of the cloudy zone in the microscopic islands where Clara is right at home. And oh, measuring the dynamic field to get it exposed with the crystallographic transformations each island undergoes. So Benjamin Weiss, time to fill up your wine cup and raise a toast to the fact that yeah, they line up. Only Benjamin would test a new PhD in physics with the flowery vintage descriptions of wine critics, but Clara's got that sensitive French wine nose, so she can smell the magnetic field inside a cloudy zone with XPM assessment of directional information, ruling out the solar nebula with radioactive dating. So we got deeper insight into a meteorite, its magnetism and its durability over time. Yeah, Clara's been in the fight, she's trying to see the insides of the cloudy zones up in that tetratinite. And yeah, she's reading it right, and now we're seeing the light. We're in inferring the parent body of a meteorite, even a meteorite that's kilometers in size, thanks to Clara Maurel's PhD insight. So break out the jars of wine to celebrate Clara's find. Sometimes they don't, but yeah, sometimes rock stars align, and we can peer inside a microscopic size and catch a glimpse of paleomagnetic time and say the core was more than 20% of a spherical 220 kilometer radius parent globe of planetesimal that lasts 80 million years or so and solidified 160 million years after T0. It's not a miracle. It's called scientific inference. It's called empirical data, experimental measurements that tell us what it might be. Like when we fly free and take measurements of the magnetic fields of psyche. Scientific advances in human knowledge enhancement, collaborating with NASA and Linda Elkins Tanton on a flyby of psyche to try to find whether magnetic activity is affected by size. Look ahead to what we can expect is quite nice. How can we tell if the magnetic vectors are aligned on a meteorite more than a meter in size? You call Clara, cause she can see the insides of the cloudy zones. There she's completely at home in them. So just build a massive magnetometer at the Smithsonian and compare data points from the millimeters going up to many meters in size to infer the asteroid. So what's the verdict, Clara? Only you can spot it. Navajo, Cranbourne, oh my God, she's got it. Every data point, take it and carefully plot it. And the magnetization is asymptotic. Yeah, get the bottle of Pinot Noir, y'all, and pop it. The cloudy zone formation model scales to bigger objects. Clara took the contrast in photoelectric microscopics and rocked it. That's a hell of a PhD project with incredible prospects for future research. No wonder the panel decided that, yup, that PhD is hers. They wanted to see deeper into the meteors, and Clara's one of the best for seeing their deep features. By comparing the magnetic allegiance of sample regions, she can assess the details in a protoplanet's features and give us insight into the ancient solar system and the molten cores of planetesimals we all know existed. That's why there was not even a chance in hell they wouldn't say anything other than, hey, Dr. Maurel. It's obvious they want her as part of their coalitions. Plus, it's obvious they really appreciate her Frenchness. Clara's so ambitious that she tests a hypothesis until it's pretty irrefutably obvious. So if you find a meteor, don't stick a magnet onto it, cause you'll erase the signal for her like a floppy disk. Clary's got the science, you can't copy it, not unless you roll with the paleogeographers who follow the magnetometers and the microscopic twists like Clara Maurel. And as a consequence, we got that deeper insight into a meteorite, its magnetism and its durability over time. Yeah, Clara's been in the fight to try to see the insides of the cloudy zones up in that tetratinite. And yeah, she's reading it right, and now we're seeing the light. We're inferring the parent body of a meteorite, even a meteorite that's kilometers in size, thanks to Clara Maurel's PhD insights. Yeah, she's reading it right, and now we're seeing the light. We're inferring the parent body of a meteorite, even a meteorite that's kilometers in size, thanks to Clara Maurel's PhD insights. We got a meteorite.
Amazing.